sexual violence is usually a weapon in war, especially in areas where there's not a lot of security. People take advantage of women and they use it as a weapon of war. And in some areas in South Sudan, if you don't have any food to give, you'll be raped. Or if you don't have any money to give, you'll be raped. And if you refuse to be raped, they'll kill your children in front of you and then you'll be killed. So you really don't have a choice. So it's a very difficult situation to be in. My name is Jaime. I am a nurse with Doctors Without Borders. In Bentiu Protection Camp, it's pretty much a swamp. There's nothing growing inside the camp. And the refugees or the people, the civilians that are getting protection, they're getting food rations, but they're not getting anything to cook their food. So a lot of the people have to leave the camp every day to collect firewood outside the camp. The men can't go because they're targets for the soldiers outside the camp. So it's usually the women and the children that leave the camp to collect firewood. And when they do, there's a lot of times we hear stories that they get raped, often gang raped, when they leave the camp to collect firewood. And for some of them, it happens every day. But a lot of the people that we encourage to come to the camp feel that there's no need for them to come. Number one, because they feel that they're quite ashamed of what happened and culturally it's not really accepted. But also they feel that it's happening to them every day and what's the need to get treatment if they're just going to get raped tomorrow. So it's very difficult situation to have an answer to, but we do provide services and we do listen to their stories and we do write them down so that there's a record of what happens, that it's not just forgotten. So this is happening all over the world. Any area where there's women fleeing, there's people that will be taking advantage of them. It's something that needs to be taken into account and to be brought up. We talk a lot about humanitarian work and medical care, but we also should also speak to the need for protection of women and to stop sexual violence.